Country Flower. You know, they make that shit. Massengale Country Flower is pooty poo freshener. That's what it is. Look, it smells like a country flower. Who wants to eat a country flower? Make a flavor we like. Chicken, beef bouillon, anything. Give me a reason to take my hat off and go down there. I feel like chicken tonight. Chicken tonight. I had three sisters growing up. There was shit in that bathtub. I didn't know what it was till I was 25 years old. Mama had that big water bottle thing hanging off in there. To me, that was just a really neat squirt gun. I was in there trying to blow it up. You can't blow that sumbitch up either. You bust a blood vessel out in your head. Don't suck on it. Mama just, get that out of your mouth. You know where that's been? She just wants to kill you because she thinks she's raising a fucking heathen. Daddy's laughing his ass off because he's in there 3 hours earlier doing the same damn thing. He didn't know what it was either. He's in the front yard watering the plants with that son of a bitch. You don't see those anymore. Water bottle, the days of the water bottle are gone. Women nowadays are just naturally fresh. They figured out soap works. I married a woman that's got an identical twin sister, and they look just alike. Naturally, my wife is, well, I mean, I married way over my fucking head. She's gorgeous. She walk in here right now, you'd go, what the fuck? How'd you get her? Personality. That's all I had. But I'll tell you this, you marry a twin, you date a twin, you fuck one, you pretty much want to fuck the other. Call me crazy. But here's some real good advice. Don't ever bring that up. That was a shitty Christmas. I got news for you. I never planned to get married. Men never plan to get married. Women do. I'm going to get married, I'm going to have a big house, and he's going to work, and I'm not. Dream on, hooker. Dream the fuck on. You want to know why a man gets married? I'll tell you why a man gets married. A man gets married because he's in a relationship so long that he just fucking gives up. All right, I'll marry you. You happy? Oh, yeah. Ha, 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 ha. Then comes the planning of the wedding, and every day is an event to her. We think about the napkins and the sign-in book and my dress and my panties and blah, 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 fucking blah. I don't give a shit. Just make sure there's beer and whiskey when the shit's over with. Because I'll tell you something, boys. At this point in time, you don't even know how bad you screwed up. You just know there's a big event coming up and somehow you're involved. Then comes the day of the wedding. You're dressed up and she's dressed up. No turning back now, is there? Mm-mm. Everybody's shaking your hand, taking your picture. Congratulations. You just want a seat in the fucking Senate for all you know. You're clueless. Coo, coo, coo. Coo, coo, coo. Afterwards, you're at the reception drinking beer with your buddies, oblivious to what the fuck you just did. Woo! You son of a bitch, you did it. You got married, you bastard. And everybody just leaves. What the fuck? Hey. Wait, where y'all going? No, don't you leave me here. Oh, shit. I gotta stay with her forever? Oh, shit. Then it dawns on you what you did. You committed. You committed forever till you are dead. It's not the emotional commitment that bothers a man. If a man tells you he loves you, he loves you. Or he's just drunk and wants a little pussy. And what's wrong with that? Nothing. Share your puss, for God's sakes. Share it with a stranger, for God's sakes. There's nothing wrong with that. It's the physical commitment that bothers a man. The long-term physical commitment. The lack of nobody else's pussy for the rest of his fucking life. Same woman, forever. Feels the same, looks the same, feels the same, looks the same, feels the same, looks the same, feels the same. Shit, it smells the same, feels the same, looks the same, feels the same, looks the same. God damn it! There's only so many green M&Ms a man can eat before he just goes, fuck, I want a red one! It's not that I don't like green M&Ms. I just don't want them every goddamn day of the week. Fuck! Shit! I want excitement. I want kinky. I don't want real kinky. I've had that, you know? Pee on me. What? I'm not going to pee on you. I got the dog in here. Let him pee on you. Shit, woman, you're weird. I'm going to tell you, it takes a lot for a man to call a woman weird in the bedroom. You have really got to do something freaky for a man to go, what the fuck? Put that stick down. Get the fuck out of here. A man has a sexual tolerance like a fucking dinosaur. He can really put up with a lot when there's a naked woman standing in front of him. I'm not shitting you. If a man came out of the bathroom in a dark corner somewhere in here and there was a woman standing next to it with her miniskirt pulled up going, look, this peanut fits right here. A man would go, what the fuck? She went, shit, it does, doesn't it? What you drinking? That's weird. But you ain't gonna tell her. Because that's some shit we don't see on a regular basis and she might stop. If there was a man over there with his pecker hanging out, rubbing pimento cheese all over it, and a woman walked by, he went, look at here. She'd go, what the fuck, are you crazy? That's where we're different. Men and women are different. Men think about pussy 24 hours a day. Now, I know a lot of you girls are going, not my man. Bullshit. I don't care if he wears a white collar to work on Sunday and carries a Bible. He's thinking about pussy. We're consumed by it. My wife asked me the other day, do you ever think about cheating on me? Every goddamn day of the week. I'm a man. I got a dick. Pussy's my friend. I can't help it. I think about it every second of the day. If you crack my head open, a million little hairy triangles would just take off running. That's the greatest marketing tool there is pussy. If you sold wheelbarrows for a living, this is all your commercial would have to consist of. A beautiful naked woman sitting in a lawn chair, no word ever said, and she just goes, mmm, and then your wheelbarrow flashes up on the screen. You couldn't sell enough fucking wheelbarrows. If you had a cereal and you called it Pussy Puffs, be a line out the grocery store, men wanting to buy themselves some Pussy Puffs. Cuckoo for Pussy Puffs. Works for a man, wouldn't work for a woman. You could not convince a woman to buy a cereal called Dickaroos. You couldn't even make the chocolatey ones a little bit bigger. That might work. Did you see them? They're huge. I ate two and I got full. I got married because I got tired of chasing it. I don't want to chase it no more. I want to come home from work, have her throw it at me. What the? I want to come home from work when she's chopping onions, throw my arms around her, rub her titties, and I don't want no shit. I love you. Quit it. No, let me see your titties. Men will act like children. Let me see your titties. I hate you. I'm running away. I'm fucking running away. Women never have to beg. Let me see your wiener. We can't get that fucker out quick enough. I've had that crazy ass woman, you know, that one that scares you a little bit, but you like it. You know? I had a woman lean over my ear one night, naked in bed, a long time ago, whisper to me, I'm gonna stick my finger in your butt. I said, no, you're not. She had big long fingernails. I could have been killed. Comedian found dead. Fingernail stuck in ass. Bled to death. Horrible. We got three children. We got three boys. Zach, Sam, and George. One syllable names, because if I get pissed, I really don't want to be thinking, you know? Bartholomew! That shit wouldn't work in my house. I got a three-year-old named Sam, naked all the time, won't wear clothes. He's like a little hippie walking around the house. I'm convinced he'd smoke dope if I let him. He walked in front of me the other night, no clothes on. I was eating Cheetos, watching TV. I just saw him out of the corner of my eye, shit in the floor, and keep walking. I just saw two brown things just come out from his ass and hit the carpet, which ain't that far, about that far. I'm not kidding. I thought, he did not just do what I think he did. And then he just turned and looked at me like, what you gonna do about it, Daddy? So I rubbed his nose in it and whipped him with a newspaper. He ain't done it since. He was taking a bath the other night. Sam is the real crazy one in the bunch. He's oblivious to anything that goes on around the house. He don't give a shit. He was sitting in the bathtub the other night. I was on the floor reading the newspaper. He has a boat with a propeller. It blows out a big, nice stream of water. He was holding it in front of him on his pecker. All he knew, the only thing he knew was it felt really good. I just noticed he got real quiet and still. And I looked over in the tub, and that little, it was hard as a rock. And we took pictures. So proud of him. I got to tell you, my wife and children left the other night and took her kids to her daddy's house. And I was alone, and I took a bath. I never take a bath. And I looked up, and there was that boat. Your children will teach you so much. I have a bigger boat now. I'll tell you what, they're the best form of birth control there is. If you don't want to have any more kids, have three. You never get a chance to do it ever again. By the time you get ready to go to bed to do it, you're so fucking tired, you just want to go to sleep. I'll see you in the morning. Honey, I think we fucked up. I miss you. I'm not shitting you. If we're going to do it, we got to do it during the day. We got to create a diversion. We get all the kids, put a Barney tape in the living room, and go, look, it's Barney. We run to the back room, slam the door. Only thing I can hear, I'm back there humping my wife, really trying to get into this. Only thing I'm hearing in the background is fucking Barney songs. I love you, you love me, we're a... Hey, Mr. Knickerbocker, boppity-bop. I like the way that you bop. Cucamara sits on the old gum tree. Mary, Mary, king of the bushes. Hey, what? Fuck! I can't even watch Barney without getting a hard-on anymore. Be sure you tip your waitstaff tonight before you leave. Every one of them got kids, none of them married. It's tragic. It really is.